Welcome to part two of the lesson on the list processing algorithm for scheduling. In this lesson, we'll take a look at an example where we also create the digraph from a priority list before creating the schedule. Let's begin by reviewing the list processing algorithm. Step one, on the digraph or priority list, we want to circle all tasks that are ready, meaning that all prerequisite tasks have been completed. Step two, we'll assign to each available processor in order the first ready task. We'll mark the task as in progress, perhaps by putting a single line through the task. Step three, we'll move forward in time until a task is completed. Mark the task as completed, perhaps by crossing out the task. And if any new tasks become ready, we'll mark them as ready. Step four, we repeat until all tasks have been scheduled. So we want to use the given priority list to create a schedule using two processors, and notice how we're given information in a table this time. Let's begin by creating a digraph. So looking at the table, notice how task 1, 2, and 3 don't have any prerequisite tasks, so we'll start with these three tasks by creating three vertices. Then we'll work our way from left to right. So this vertex represents task 1, this represents task 2, and this represents task 3. Let's put the time requirement in parentheses. Let's assume these are hours. Task 1 takes 9 hours, task 2, 11, and task 3, 3. So we'll have in parentheses a 9 here, 11 here, and 3 here. And now looking at task 4, there are two prerequisite tasks. Task 1 and 2 must be completed before starting task 4. So if this vertex represents task 4 that takes 12 hours, we'll draw an arrow from task 1 to task 4, as well as an arrow from task 2 to task 4. This represents that task 4 cannot be started until tasks 1 and 2 are first complete. Task 5 has two prerequisite tasks, task 1 and 3. So if this vertex represents task 5, that takes 7 hours, there'll be an arrow from task 1 to task 5, as well as an arrow from task 3 to task 5. Task 6 has a prerequisite task of task 3, so if this is task 6 that takes 5 hours, we'll have an arrow from task 3 to task 6. Task 7 has a prerequisite task of task 4, so if this is task 7 that takes 8 hours, we'll have an arrow from task 4 to task 7. Task 8 also has a prerequisite task of task 4. So if this is task 8 that takes 2 hours, there'll be an arrow from task 4 to task 8. Finally, task 9 has two prerequisite tasks, tasks 5 and 6. So if this is task 9 that takes 2 hours, there'll be an arrow from task 5 to task 9, and an arrow from task 6 to task 9. And we'll use one more vertex here to represent the end, or when the project is complete. So we'll draw an arrow from task 9 to the end, task 8 to the end, and task 7 to the end. This is our completed digraph, which we'll also use now to create our schedule. And here's the same digraph generated by a computer. So now we'll use the priority list and our digraph to create a schedule using two processors. So we'll let this first row be processor 1 and the second row be processor 2. We begin by circling the ready tasks, which are the tasks with no prerequisite tasks, which are tasks 1, 2, and 3. The highest priority ready task will now be assigned to processor 1, which is task 1. Task 1 takes 9 hours. Now task 1 is in progress, which will identify with a single line through task 1. The next highest priority ready task is task 2, which will now be assigned to processor 2. Task 2 takes 11 hours. Task 2 is now in progress. After 9 hours, task 1 becomes complete. So we'll put an X through task 1 to identify it's complete. Notice there are no new ready tasks. Notice task 4 also requires task 2 to be complete. So the only ready task is task 3, which is now assigned to processor 1. Task 3 takes 3 hours. 9 plus 3 is 12. Task 3 is now in progress. Notice after 11 hours, task 2 becomes complete. So when task 2 is complete, notice how now task 4 becomes ready. Task 4 is the highest priority ready task, which is now assigned to processor 2. Task 4 takes 12 hours. 11 plus 12 is 23. So task 4 is now in progress. After 12 hours, task 3 becomes complete. So task 3 is now complete. Notice how there are now two new ready tasks. Task 6 is now ready, and so is task 5. Notice task 5 required both task 1 and 3 to be complete, which they now are. So task 5 and 6 are now ready. Task 6 is the highest priority ready task, so task 6 is now assigned to processor 1. Task 6 takes 5 hours. 12 plus 5 is 17. Task 6 is now in progress. So task 6 is in progress. After 17 hours, notice task 6 is complete. So we'll mark task 6 as complete here and here. Notice there are no new ready tasks, which means now task 5 is assigned to processor 1. Task 5 takes 7 hours. So 17 plus 7 would be 24. And task 5 is now in progress. So in progress, in progress. After 23 hours, task 4 becomes complete. Task 4 is here and here. Notice when task 4 is complete, there are two new ready tasks. Task 7 is now ready, and so is task 8. Task 7 is the highest priority ready task, which is now assigned to processor 2. Task 7 takes 8 hours. So 23 plus 8 would be 31. Task 7 is now in progress. After 24 hours, task 5 becomes complete. And therefore now task 9 is ready. Notice task 9 required both task 5 and task 6 to be completed before it was ready. So the highest priority ready task is task 9, which requires 2 hours. So 24 plus 2 is 26. Task 9 is now in progress. After 26 hours, task 9 is complete. And therefore, the remaining task, task 8, is assigned to processor 1. Task 8 takes 2 hours. 26 plus 2 is 28. Task 8 is now in progress. Now that all the tasks have been assigned, the schedule is complete. But let's go ahead and continue. Notice after 28 hours, task 8 becomes complete. And then after 31 hours, task 7 is complete, and the project has ended. So looking at our schedule here, notice that the total project time with two processors is 31 hours, and also that processor 1 is idle for the last 3 hours. And here's the same schedule in color, if that's easier to read. Again, this is processor 1, this is processor 2, and this was idle time. I hope you found this helpful.